Hi guys, we are just 30 days away from NABARD examination. Welcome to the lesson. My name is Anuj Jindal, and today we are going to discuss another 5 questions. And this time, these questions are important for the upcoming NABARD and RBI examination from ESI section. So what I'm going to discuss today is Niti Aayog's recent year-end review of the year 2018. Instead of covering the entire current affairs of 2018, why don't we cover all the important aspects? Well, Niti Aayog's year-end review of 2018 is one of them. So let's pick up some questions and understand what Niti Aayog has said about the year 2018. As you can see here, this is the PDF for all the questions that I'm going to pick up from Niti Aayog's year-end review 2018 that I have created after going through the entire report. Let's go through the first question. The question says, which of the following indices have not been released by Niti Aayog in order to measure performance of states in various social welfare indicators? So the keywords here are indices and not been released by Niti Aayog. Remember, as soon as you go through a question, the first objective is to identify the keywords before moving to the answer choices. Because even if you have not read about a particular topic, you can eliminate some choices and try and answer that question if you are able to identify keywords like I have identified them here. Let's have a look at the options. Digital Transformation Index. The keyword here is digital, not transformation. Second is Health Index. The keyword again here is health. Third is Composite Water Management Index. The keyword here is water. School Education Quality Index, the keyword here is education, and Corruption Intensity Index, the keyword here is corruption. Try and answer this question on your own in the comment section below, and then I will have a look at the answers. The answer to this question is E, Corruption Intensity Index. A very factual question indeed, but the important point here is to know and remember all major indices that have been released by Niti Aayog. Well, let's have a look at all major indices. Number one is Digital Transformation Index, D, that's how we can remember it. Health Index, H, that's how we can remember it. Composite Water Management Index, that's how we can remember water. School Education Index, so D, E, H, W. District Hospital Index, another H. State Energy Index, you have another E. SDG India Index, you have SDG, which can be a separate acronym, and Agriculture Marketing and Farmer Friendly Reforms. So Agriculture Marketing and Farmer Friendly Reforms, A. So the acronym that you can create, or you can even simplify it later, I'm just creating it right now for you. AD square, H square, W, that is something that you can create. These are all the indices that have been created by Niti Aayog /SDG, that is another index that have been created by the Aayog. So this is how you can try and remember things which are difficult to remember normally, okay? And that's how I am trying to simplify your prep, because we have only 1 month left for the examination. The second question, which of the following is the full form of SAATH? A favorite question of both NABARD and RBI. They ask a lot of questions like this. Let's have a look at the options. Sustainable Action for Transforming Human Capital. Sustainable Action for Transforming Human Health. Sustainable Action for Transforming Health. Sustainable Action for Transforming Educational Health. So what are the keywords that we have? Human Capital, Human Health, Transforming Health, and Transforming Educational Health. Okay, let's have a look at the answer. If you know the answer already, make sure that you type the answer in the comment section below. Why do I say that? Because it boosts up your confidence and at the same time also helps you understand whether whatever you know is actually right or wrong. So it's very important that you pen it down somewhere, whether it's in your copy, it's in your notebook, or in the comment section below. The answer to this question is A, Sustainable Action for Transforming Human Capital. What is the objective of SAATH initiative, Sustainable Action for Transforming Human Capital? The first important thing to remember here is, it is the states which have requested Niti Aayog to help them in providing technical support in order to improve their performance on health and educational sectors. So it is not the center or the Niti Aayog which is asking the states, going to the states and saying, hey states, do something about education and health, you are not doing enough. It's the state looking up to Niti Aayog and saying that we need technical support, so please provide us with something so that we can transform and improve our performance or the condition of education and health. The program will be launched in 3 selected states. So all the 28 states, although have applied for this, only 3 states will finally be selected, and in those 3 states Niti Aayog is going to provide a pilot program wherein technical support is going to be provided for education and health sectors. Okay, let's go to the third question, EBSP. Now the first another question that can be asked from there is, what is the full form of EBSP? If you know it already, mention it in the comment section below so that I know how many of you actually remember the full form of EBSP. EBSP stands for Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat. Okay, so EBH SHBH, that's how you can remember it, is being promoted by which ministry? Which ministry is promoting it? If you know the objective of Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat, it's easier to know the ministry involved in Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat, and that's how we are going to revise or do today, because the next question is also going to be connected with this. Well, the answer to this question is C, Ministry of Culture, and I will tell you why is it Ministry of Culture. You will understand it yourself once we discuss the objectives. That's the purpose of these videos, to celebrate the unity in diversity. So we have got an acronym or a keyword here through which we have created an acronym, D, diversity of our nation, to celebrate the unity in diversity of our nation, to promote the spirit of national integration. We can actually call it as UID. The second one is national integration, to promote the spirit of national integration. Although the website highlights these, it highlights these, celebrate or promote, but instead I want to highlight these because these are the actual keywords. To showcase the rich heritage and culture. So another keyword we have found here, H. See, I'm simplifying all of these things for you. To establish long-term engagements and to create an environment which promotes learning between states by sharing best practices and experiences. So engagement and learning, E and L. We have the entire acronym which simplifies and compresses the objectives of Niti, objective of Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat. So you just need to remember is, remember this one, UID, NI, HEL or HLE. HLE is actually better to remember. So this is the acronym which you can note down in your notes, and this will help you remember everything about Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat, Ministry of Culture. Let's come to the next question. The question says, which of the following is not an objective of Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat? So we have just revised or gone through the objectives. We have also simplified them. So going through these objectives and identifying which one is incorrect should be a piece of cake. To celebrate the unity in diversity, yes. To promote the spirit of national integration, NI, yes. To showcase the rich heritage, H, yes. To create an environment which promotes learning, L. To integrate Bharatmala among all states for better connectivity, B. This is, well, this is not a part of the acronym which we had created. So this here is the answer for you. So you can see how creating acronyms, even when they feel like it's difficult to remember, actually become so easy to remember by using or creating such acronyms and noting it down in your notebooks. That's how you can simplify your preparation in these remaining 30 days. Let's come to the last question for today. According to an ordinance, Medical Council of India has been replaced by a Board of Governors headed by. So Medical Council of India, MCI, has been replaced by a Board of Governors which is to be headed by a member of Niti Aayog, and that is why this holds a lot of importance. And who is this member of Niti Aayog? VK Paul. VK Paul is the name of the member of Niti Aayog who is to head the Board of Governors, which is going to replace Medical Council of India. Another important information, who is the ex-officio head of Niti Aayog? It's the Prime Minister, sitting Prime Minister of the country, which in this case right now is Narendra Modi. Okay, so these were the important questions for today. Tomorrow we will be coming out with, I will be creating more videos wherein we will be discussing more such questions. And the purpose of these videos or these questions is not just information. At the same time, it's also to simplify your education, simplify your learning, so that in these 30 days, you can actually use a lot more things, okay? And remember a lot more things than you would actually, or you would in reality be able to remember. If you like this lesson, please subscribe to the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon, because that's how you will get notifications about the future videos that I create. All the very best. Take care.